Hi guys, Dr. Steen here. Let's talk about cancer of the colon and rectum. First of all, let's talk about anatomy. The intestinal tract is as follows. Food travels from your mouth through the esophagus into the stomach, then into the small intestine, which loops around and eventually empties into the colon and the right lower abdomen. The valve between the small bowel and the colon is called the ileocecal valve. The very first portion of the colon next to the ileocecal valve is called the cecum, and the appendix is a long, hollow outpouching from the cecum. The colon then runs up the right side of the abdomen and is generally called the right colon. It turns at the liver, runs across the abdomen to the left side, generally called the transverse colon, down the left side, generally called the descending colon. It loops in a C or an S shape called the sigmoid colon, and then down through the pelvic soft tissue as the rectum and out as the anus. The turn up near the liver is called the hepatic flexure, since it is near the liver, and the turn in the left upper abdomen is called the splenic flexure, since it is near the spleen. The colon is in the sac of the abdomen that contains the abdominal organs, whereas the rectum is surrounded by the fat and muscle of the pelvis. The rectum is usually about 12 to 15 centimeters long, and it varies based on body size. For surgical purposes, we essentially break the rectum down into an upper rectum, which is 10 to 15 centimeters from the anus, measuring up from below, the middle rectum, which is 5 to 10 centimeters from the anal opening, and the lower rectum, which is the lowest area of rectum just above the anus. Again, this varies from person to person. When you get a colonoscopy, it is easy to tell the distance from the anal opening for the first 20 centimeters or so. But after that, locating where you are in the colon is tricky. We can tell somewhat where we are from inside the colon at the turns of the splenic flexure and the hepatic flexure, but we don't really know where we are again until we see the junction between the small intestine and the colon again, called the ileocecal valve. So we know with good accuracy if we see a colon cancer within a foot or so of the ileocecal valve and within a foot or so from the anal opening. But the rest of the colon is more of an estimate when we are looking at it just from a colonoscopy. This is why most of the time when we find a colon cancer or a rectal cancer, we inject ink into the wall of the colon to mark it permanently with a tattoo, so we can see where the cancer is located from the outside of the colon when we do surgery. Colon cancer refers to cancer that occurs from the ileocecal valve and anywhere through the colon down to the rectum. For a surgeon, the major treatment differences between colon cancer and rectal cancer are differentiated by the point at which the rectum goes into the soft tissue of the pelvis and leaves the abdominal space sac. Anything above this point, colon in the abdominal sac, is treated like colon cancer, and anything that is surrounded by the fat and muscle of the pelvis is treated like rectal cancer. I am commonly asked what causes colon cancer. In general, we think that most colon cancers grow from precancerous, mushroom-like growths on the inside of the colon called polyps. When a polyp turns into a colon or rectal cancer, it is called adenocarcinoma. This is by far the most common form of colon and rectal cancer. When you start getting a colonoscopy at 45 years of age or maybe even earlier, the doctor is looking for polyps. Not every kind of polyp will turn into a cancer. The doctor will be sure to figure out if you have the dangerous kind or not. The goal of a colonoscopy is to find the polyps and remove them before they can turn into cancer. It takes many years for the progression from polyp to cancer, which is why getting a colonoscopy is okay every 10 years, unless the doctor finds a polyp, in which case you should do a repeat colonoscopy in 5 years, or even sooner perhaps. Typically, once a colon or rectal cancer is found on colonoscopy, we want to do a CT scan of your chest and abdomen to be sure it has not spread or metastasized to other organs, such as the liver or the lungs. These pictures are done before doing surgery. Most colon cancers grow in the right side of the colon or the last part of the colon in the C or S-shaped portion called the sigmoid colon. It is less common to get cancer in the middle part called the transverse colon. If we find a cancer in the right side of the colon or the cecum, we remove the entire right side of the colon. We need to remove much more than just the small area of cancer because for all true colon cancer, we want to remove at least a dozen lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are all over your body. They are part of your immune system. In the colon, the lymph nodes tend to filter out cancer cells that get stuck in the lymph node, and these can grow. We want to know if the cancer cells have spread to the lymph nodes, and obviously we want to remove the lymph nodes if they have cancer in them. In the colon, the lymph nodes are intertwined with the blood vessels going to the colon. So in order to remove enough lymph nodes, 12 at least, we have to remove the blood vessels to the entire right colon. This is why the entire right colon is removed for any cancer located anywhere from the cecum to the transverse colon. After the right colon is removed, we can attach the last part of the small intestine back to the transverse colon. Cancer in the right colon rarely needs an ostomy bag, since we can almost always reattach the small intestine to the colon. Cancer in the transverse colon is a special case. This is up to the surgeon how they remove that portion, but cancer in this location is relatively rare. Cancer in the descending or sigmoid colon is removed by taking enough colon out to allow for 12 lymph nodes also. Because the sigmoid colon naturally snakes around, it can be easier to remove if cancer is in this floppy section. And we can remove the 12 lymph nodes and blood vessels that are intertwined with the lymph nodes just by removing a sigmoid colon and then pulling the remaining colon together. This would rarely need an ostomy. An ostomy is when we cannot safely put the intestinal tract back together again. A colostomy is a portion of the colon that is brought up to the skin and open so that stool can come out into a bag. I hope this helps. This is an overview of colon cancer. Rectal cancer is an entirely different topic and is addressed in a different video. Don't forget to subscribe below, check out my other videos. Take care.